slam, and the cookbook said, cook until done. So it's going to remain unfinished now. They've just decided it's finished. But because the needle spire on top is really considered the architectural top of the building, that means that architects from all around the world, just about 2 years back, have decided and agreed that that is the height of the building. Not the floors, but the needle spire on top. It's as opposed to like the Empire State Building, where part of the needle is actually an antenna, right? So they have to stop at a certain point, and then there's a little more needle, right? So in the old Twin Towers, it was just the floor, because then there was like this arbitrary needle off the side, and that was for our phones, etc. So when the Twin Towers fell, of course, we lost all cell service, right? Okay, so that's number one there, number seven behind, number four. The twins were 108 stories altogether, right? And I can't remember the actual footage, so sorry about that. Just a little bit taller in the floors, but shorter, much shorter than the needle itself, by nearly 400 feet. Yeah. Okay, so now we know where 1, 2 is supposed to be. 3 we're going to see again when we clear the trees. 4 right here. And now number 5 was intended to be right beyond that area in a little space that, you know, no one thinks it's going to be done anymore. There's been two or more years since there's been any talk of it. If you look it up online, you find the original drawing of it, and that's it, basically. No more conversation. It's actually hard to find anything on number 5 without finding stuff about the old number 5, right? So it's tricky. Number 6 was intended to be right here, right in front of us, but it was moved, basically, to the other side. It hasn't been started yet. Frank Gehry was doing this design. Remember I showed you the wavy building, right? So he's doing the design. It's going to be a performing arts center. So it was redesignated as a performing arts center. It was going to be $700,000. Million dollars, right? Dropped down to $500 million, and they still, Frank Gehry is still fighting it. He doesn't have a new drawing yet because the first design that he did of it, they rejected. So imagine being one of the most famous architects in the world and your design is rejected, right? So lots of politics going on. I explained this morning, so I started to think that I was repeating myself, but the tower number 1, a lot of people call it the Freedom Tower, right? The Freedom Tower is no longer accurate. This is tower number 1 because the Freedom Tower was the name for the first 2 years when Daniel Lieberstein was the architect. He didn't see eye to eye with the development of the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey. He dropped out of the picture or was asked to step down or what have you. And then David Childs took over. David Childs and committee decided, let's revert back to the old addresses, number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and Larry Silverstein's building, number 7. Right now, Larry Silverstein is much more involved. Why? Because it's not part of government. Port Authority of New York and New Jersey is the pseudo-governmental body that has to deal with taxes and bureaucracy. Larry Silverstein, private sector. Much more money, much more power, much more wealthy friends. So now he puts money into the other buildings and he's getting a lot more credit now for the other buildings. Like you'll see on number 4, it actually says Silverstein. Right, so there you go. Number 3 just got the green light about a little over a year ago. It was stopped for a really long time. That's why it's at this halfway point now. $169 million was freed up from insurance money that was in escrow. And then another $1 billion added on by Larry Silverstein. So again, he's going, you know, adding to the pot. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cut, 6 moved, 7 over there, right? Let's go over to the falls now. I like to go always to this little center section so we can see the way the names